everyone, Retro Girls UK back for a brand new video, and on today's video we'll be showing this week's video game pickups that we got from either eBay, CX, charity shops. We didn't record in the CX or charity shops this week, unfortunately, and we had some pickups up online, especially one super rare game that is very hard to find in the UK and it cost us over £200. So if you're new to this channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button, don't forget to hit the notification bell to get the latest updates, and keep tuned because near the end I'll be showing the rare game and I'll be telling you more about a giveaway that we'll be doing on the channel soon. So let's get into it. So let's get into all the video games that we picked up. So, and the funny story is, the super rare game isn't the one that you see on the thumbnail. It is another game. I will give you a hint. It's a PS1 game, so stay tuned to the end to know about this. And to tell you all the details about the giveaways that will be coming soon on our social medias. So, the first game we picked up, as you would have known, just you've seen it in the thumbnail, that is Blowout. This is the NES game. This, as you can see, cost... Let me just get the focus. Alright, you can't not focus if it says $4.99. This is from Coventry. This is like a new store that you went to. You would have seen on our movie and TV pickups video that we picked up some 4Ks from the store as well. So don't forget to go and check that out. So that's the first one. I'm super happy because we only own about 5 or 6 NES games, and that's like Gremlins and Chippendale, what else, to be honest.
It's Simpsons, isn't it?
Simpsons and TMNT, and I can't remember what the other one was. So not many games, unfortunately, but I'm super happy that the artwork is in really good condition. There's no actual scratches on there. And this is £6 at CEX, and it's not local to us, so it would have cost us £8, but I'm well happy because we saved a couple of money. A couple of pounds. So then, he's just laughing behind the camera. So the next one is... It is a PlayStation hard drive. This is 2 terabytes. I regret not paying the extra to get the 4 terabyte one. I think I paid £60 for this, sort of. I wasn't too happy. We were out of Blackpool and they left this in the recycling bin. It's a good job it wasn't recycling day, because they would have took this. And I was too happy because the bin lid was on. Imagine if it rained. So this is for, not actually for the PS4. That you would have seen on previous week. This is for the PS5, which we did pick up recently. Lisa, go and grab the box at the hall, please.
Okie dokie.
So while Lisa's grabbing the box of the PS5, I will let you know we did save up for ages for the PS5, and I'm super happy with it because that means now we own 2 PS5s to the collection because we have most new gen consoles. We have 2 of each. It's already unboxed. Hold on. So this is the edition we had. We had the FIFA 23. Edition. This came with the digital download, and you would have seen on here, and I love it because now we can play certain games against each other. Unfortunately, I can't play EA games online because it would not let me link my PlayStation account. I've been trying, but I could play on the Xbox. Just so happy about. I'm happy now because it was such a pain when we was playing PS5 games that Lisa may have been playing one game and then we had to wait, or Lisa was waiting for me. Wasn't it, Lisa, a pain?
Yeah, it was a pain, yeah.
Yes, now we're on 2 to the collection. It did cost us over £500, but if you're lucky enough and you're after it and you're willing to pay the price of what the stores sell them for, like Covey's, Argos, Smith's Toys, it's well worth looking at, because I've heard people say they can't get the console, but I've checked different areas in the Midlands and nearly every store by us has a PlayStation 5 for sale. Especially, we did get the disc version, which is the harder one to get hold of. We was going to buy it at CX, but I said I didn't want to risk it paying vouchers. So as you would have seen in previous videos, we spent the voucher on something else. So, we've got 2 Switch game pickups this week. Unfortunately, there's no cart in the box because they're in my Switch case. So, the first one is Crash Insane Trilogy. I do own this on the PS4. I love this. We even own Crash Bandicoot 1, the first one, on the PS1. I want to get the rest on PS1 to go with the set. With this one, it's blank inside, but it's advertising Crash Team Racing. I think that was like £20. The next one I've been after for ages. I own this on the Wii U. I own the Wii U version. This is Yoshi's Crafted World. I was playing this in the car on the way to Blackpool, and it was really good. It is 2-player. What I love about the Nintendo exclusive games, look at the artwork inside there. It's showing you about the control, but look at how nice that is. And it's lovely and vibrant, the artwork. What should I go for next? Okay, I'll go for the PS2 games. I'll keep the two rare items for last. Oh, we had two pickups on CX in Coventry? Yeah, Lisa's bobbing her head behind the background. So this is Rune, Viking Warlord, yeah. We didn't record this one, we just wanted to go out and just see what we picked up. And this is complete with, as Lisa would say,
Manwan.
Yep. And as it states on the back, it's going to make anyone laugh. Before guns, men had balls. It literally states that on the cover there. Does look quite good for £2. We got this off a voucher. We had a £220-something voucher. So we had that. The £200 of the voucher did go on a game. The next one is another PS2 game. This is CT Special Forces Firefight Effect. It reminds me a bit of Splinter Cell / Call of Duty, and I don't know if it's got Manuel. It does have a Lisa. What does it have?
Manuel as well.
So we'll get on to the PS1 games, and then we've got three PS1 games, which are quite commonish, and then two super rare games, so PS1, PS2. So the first one we had come today, the box is smashed, but we only paid £2 out of eBay, so I'm not really too bothered. This is Truck Racing. I can always replace the cases. The cases are quite common to get hold of. This doesn't have a manual, but the disc is in minty condition. And that's what it looks like. You see my reflection of the phone and Lisa. Wave to the camera. So this is what it looks like on the back. And we do love our racing games. For a couple of quids, not bad. We do have some more PS1 games. So if you hit that notification bell, you'll see when the next video goes live after this. We have some other awesome games coming. And I am out to go and get a Harry Potter game, which is over 50 odd quid. But you'll have to wait and see on the videos, for the upcoming videos, to see where and what console I decide to buy it on. Because that would be an awesome pickup for me, for my last one for the set. Lisa can already gather that it's going to be an expensive game. Mm-hmm. The next one is a game, I didn't pay $6.99, that's a 4K label, it's a foot sticker. Is World's Scariest Police Chases. The box is a bit cracked, but I don't really mind. The seller sold these all, and they're so in minty condition, so I can't complain. It does come in the artwork. Activision leaflet does come with the
manual,
exactly. Mm-hmm. And that's the disc, and the case has just come apart. That's how knackered the case is. But that's what it looks like. I've watched the gameplay to this, and it looks really good. Let me just put Lisa, can you do that for me, please? I'm a domestic. The next one, a funny story. We went to get the rare game for CX Coventry, Hertford Street. And we asked them to get this. Because we went and got the rare game separately. We went back late on the day to get some 4Ks. And we picked up this. It was behind the counter. So this was £5. So I'll tell you the story about this then. We tell you about it and I'll tell you the story. So this is two discs, which I didn't know. They are minty condition. It does come with the manual. Or manual, as Lisa would say. And we paid for the items. We got out of the store. And we went down to the train station. As we was there, we was putting stuff in the bag. And Lisa wanted to double check the receipt. So we double checked the receipt. And Lisa realised that. What did they not do, Lise?
They didn't scan it.
They didn't scan it, so we didn't get charged for it. And by the time we was at the train station, our train was due, we couldn't go back. And they just didn't scan it, and it was his own fault because he literally got it. I won't show it on camera, but he literally slammed it down on the counter. And I was thinking, why would you slam someone's purchase that they're buying? And secondly, if you slam something like this down on the counter, it's gonna get smashed. And I don't mind about this. I know it's a platinum edition. I don't mind. I actually like the platinum edition. I think it looks nice on the shelves. So I'm really happy about this. We had this on a recommendation from who, Lisa? Siobhan, as Lisa would say.
Siobhan.
Yeah, Siobhan. Thank you very much for the recommendation. I picked this up. So, last two games. Which one shall I keep to last, Lise?
Keep that one to last.
Okay. So, you would have seen on our TikTok, if you follow us on there, we did pick a game up. I just had to take some parts of England. That was Toy Story 3 and the PS2. This is quite uncommon at CX. I think there's only three copies left. One's at Dudley. I'm sure when I went last time, that was a reprinted cover. Don't correct me, there might have been a new one since then. And two at another store. So we picked this up at a local store, and that was Chelmsley Wood. And we don't normally get quite rare games in there. So we paid £18 for this. And this, I didn't even know until a while back that you could get this on PS3. This must have been on the PS3. PS2, a Toy Story 3, I'll get my words correct. So Lisa went and Courtney picked this up for me. I didn't know about it. And the only thing is it doesn't come in manual, but I'm not too bothered. Bit of a problem is, we put it in, it loads, it gets to the menu. And there's a few scratches there, but we're going to take it back and get it discreet. You can't really see on the camera. Lisa said the man had a look. Was it a man?
Yeah.
The man had a look, and she was telling me that he checked it, said it didn't need cleaning. I swear he needs to go to Specsavers because there's like loads of scratches on it. But I'm not too bothered because it does loads. So I reckon a disc clean would do quite well on this. So we'll be taking this back maybe tomorrow. Well, I say me. Lisa will probably take it back because she wants to go and look at the store anyway. And we're going to get this. If not, you're going to go to Dudley and ask them, will they swap the discs maybe or something. I'm not too fussed. If not, I will pick up on eBay. Just there's one copy left from the UK at the moment of recording this. I think that was £20 or best offer. But I'm really happy about this. It's one of these games that will be part of the collection. I love my Toy Story. I love Toy Story 2. I can never get past the sewer mission. I don't know why. I just need a game going. As you'd see, let me see, there's no bank detail. That is a fit Lisa traded in. It was all like 10p stuff. So it was like 10p films. Stuff that you would see on that VHS pickup. But they had a bundle of DVDs. So most of we got from there. So it's 10p, 20p. And Lisa only had to put £2.50, yeah, £2.50 because you traded in a bunch of stuff, which I'm just quite happy about. You are
foreign cover.
Oh yeah, it's a foreign cover, but it does paint English. I think all the Toy Stories are foreign cover because when I looked at eBay, others like this, but it does paint English. It takes a bit longer to load because you can hear that the delays are trying to work. Gets as far as loading the first mission and then it freezes. So hopefully that gets fixed. Lisa, would you do the honours and put the thing in there?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, we've got last pickup. All right. That is, let me think, I don't know which way it's going to look. Tombi on the PS1 that costs £200 voucher. And yes, before anyone says it, it is a reprinted cover, but I will tell you a story. Lisa was looking on the store, there's only a couple in stock, and she went to her local CX store where she was trading in some stuff. We traded in most of the PS4 games we don't play and about 6 or 7 Switch games. I don't know if I've got the pictures. If I have the pictures, I'll put them somewhere. If I don't have the pictures, you'll see no pictures on the video. Yeah, basically. So the good thing with this, there's good and bad things about this. It does come with a noise manual. And we would never pay £200 cash. Well, I was willing to pay £200 cash because it's for Lisa. And I love her, so she gets it. But funny story is, we know it's a front cover, a reprinted cover. We did take this with us to Blackpool. And she was going to see what the condition was like of the Blackpool one, the official cover. But it was all ripped, weren't it?
Yeah, it was.
Ripped and rotten. And the back and the disc was scratched to hell. So it's come with the manual. And that is a disc. Lovely, nice. Look, matching hair. Other than the blue. And the disc is in minty condition, so we can't complain about that. For anyone who has doesn't know about this, I'll try and find some gameplay to put on the screen for you somewhere in between this, which most likely will happen. Unfortunately, it is a reprinted cover. Whoever did attempt it, at least. But we're going to make our own cover for this. Lisa said maybe in the future if she sees it again, also sees this selling cheap, just someone selling a disc and a cover, she'll buy it, get them, sell the disc again to make a little bit of money back, and then have that. But are you too fussed about the front cover?
No, it was more the manual.
It was more the manual, because Lisa's been after, she's after Tombi 2, so I had an itch on my shoulder. So that's what it looks like, as you can tell, it's ripped there. But my dad does some awesome reproduction covers you would see on other videos of That is what it looks like. That is the most awesome find. I definitely will try to find the gameplay, because anyone has never played this game, I've never played this. I've played Tombi 2 on a demo disc many, many years ago. Excuse me, I need to just drink one second. Anything you got to say about this, Lise?
It is one of the best games out there on the PS1. I absolutely love it. And it was a dream of mine to finally own it for myself.
Yeah, Lisa won't come on camera. She's had a shower and her hair's like... Yeah, and she's editing it in behind the scenes. So, that is everything. I would recommend this. This is one of the rare games. You do want to get Tombi 2 for the set. That's £165 game at CX when it does go in stock. But I'm thinking about maybe after Christmas or maybe after our holiday next year that we're going to buy it. We are after Cooler World. What we try to do is buy stuff for the collection, play the games. If we complete them, we'll trade them in, build up another voucher. And I think most of the games, what was the games we traded in, Liz? It was like common Switch games, like games I wouldn't play.
Pokemon Sword,
or it could have been Shield. And we traded that in. We traded in some PS4 games like Just Cause. I traded in Minecraft, which is common. I can pick that up any time with me. People are always selling it for like £5-10. So I was willing to trade stuff in to get this game, as you never see this very often. The good thing is, if you go to your local CX and you want something and it's a rare game, ask them to see if they can phone another store for you. And most times, if they're nice enough for you or you're polite to them, because I've heard the way people speak to the workers in CX, and sometimes they don't deserve it, do they?
No.
Unless they're being arseholes. There's a polite way of putting it. So, that is everything we have for today. Can I have my toy soon? So that, please, thank you. Mm-hmm. So that is everything we have today. These are the two rare games. That's the most... Really weird. Rare game, cheaper. Rare game, extortionate. £200. But we didn't pay cash. We paid vouchers, and both of these did come off vouchers. Cost £2. And you wouldn't believe how much we got for all the stuff we traded in. Like, I think it was like £230. And it wasn't that much. It was about 12 games. So it's always worth looking out on your local selling places, Facebook Marketplace, Spock. I'd recommend picking up Switch games. Just make sure that they have the UK rating on. That is a bit of a tip. Make sure that look for UK rating and always check your prices. It's always worth looking at charity shops, because you do find that some PS2 games you get £4 or £5 voucher. So that is everything we picked up for this week. We do have some more games. Maybe you might see some rare games in the next one. So we hope you enjoyed today's video. Don't forget, comment down below what the question of today is.
I've got a question of today. If you're an avid gamer like me and Michelle, what is the rarest PS1 game you've got in your collection?
Or PS2.
Yeah.
What's the rare game for? Or if you don't own PS1 or PS2, what's the rarest game that you own in your collection? And one other question for me, do you own Tombi or do you own Tombi 2? So thank you for watching, and we'll see you on the next video.